to your radio school, where we bring you lessons in maths, English, civic education, and basic science for JS2 students. Here, we engage you with great quality, lively, and exciting lessons in this new approach to learning. Come join us and listen. Today's lesson starts now. Let us meet our teacher. Welcome to our Radio School English Language lesson, and if you're just joining us today, the topic we're going to look at is vocabulary development. Words associated with work, words associated with unemployment, which has become a menace in Nigeria today. So we're going to look at unemployment, and how are we going to do that? We are going to read a comprehension passage in our favorite textbook, The New Concept, English Language from JSS. I love this textbook, and I want to advise my friends at home, make sure you have a copy. Even if your school is not using this textbook, I want you to get one for yourself, because they've really broken things down and done things in such a way that it is easy for you to even pick this textbook and educate yourself. So today we'll be looking at page 155 of our new concept, and the topic is increasing rate of unemployment. What's the topic of our last lesson?
Consonant sounds.
So how many sounds did we look at? Could you tell us the sounds?
Four sounds.
So what's the first one? The second one?
The third one?
Yes. You say it's the J letter. What is sound? It is what?
You have it in yes. You have it in yellow.
You. Yes. It's not the J sound. What about the fourth one? We. Thank you very much. Okay, today we're going to read the comprehension passage. After reading the passage, we're going to learn new words associated with unemployment at work, and then use these words in sentences. We would also use a dictionary to find the meanings of those words. Okay, my fun fact is a riddle. What five-letter word? What five-letter word becomes shorter when you add two letters to it? What five-letter word becomes shorter as you add two letters to it? Okay, I already have hands raised up here in the classroom. I want to give my friends at home an opportunity to answer this question. What five-letter word becomes shorter when you add two letters? The five-letter word becomes shorter when you add two letters to it. Okay? Habiba is itching to give me the answer.
The answer is sure.
Put your hands together for her. Again, the answer is what?
Short.
The answer is short. S-H-O-R-T. And how many letters is short?
Five.
And when you add E-R to it, becomes what?
Now that we know what this subject is, let's find out how this works in real life.
Actually, like any other human being, my likes would include possibly sports, because I have great interest in that. I also think of some areas where persons may venture into, for instance, like adventures, trying to search for new grounds and have new experiences in virtually any field that I come across. I may say I have some sort of inquisitive mind, and that on its own also gives me, I think, the drive to search for knowledge beyond what I already know. And talking about that, the primary aim of all of that is to see what is really ahead of me, or what is outside of my scope of knowledge and experience I can explore to better myself and again impact the society.
What about dislikes?
My dislikes, lies under some. If you talk about what, not just human beings, but for the human beings, I hate lies with a passion. I hate people who are lazy and lousy, pardon my language, who are not serious enough with what they do, what they think about themselves and life. People who are too casual don't quite appeal to me. But if you talk about some abstract things and maybe some other parts of human endeavor, I don't really like a situation where things are so disorganized. I don't also have the mind to really accept a situation where it's like no man's land, every kind of thing goes. I think those kind of situations really put me off. So my likes are very simple and my dislikes are also very, very simple.
Now that you have heard about this subject in real life, let's go back to the classroom and hear what the teacher has to say about it.
Okay, welcome back from a real life example. And now we're going to read the comprehension passage on page 155. Are you there?
Yes,
page 155. And what's the title? Farmer. subjects of voluntary employment and see the questions? Okay, we're going to take the questions one by one. I'm going to give you 2 minutes to read the comprehension passage again on your own. Remember, in the examination, or if you're giving the comprehension passage to me, after reading the comprehension passage the first time, read it again. You're supposed to read it at least 2 or 3 times so you can get a clear picture of what it's talking about. And now when you're looking at the questions, what do you do? Go back. You know where to go and get the answer. Once you read, what is this one? You know which paragraph to go and get the answer. Okay, I believe we're done. So now let's look at the first question. What is another name for unemployment? I have so many answers. What is another name for unemployment? Yes, would you?
Another name for unemployment is called joblessness.
Thank you very much. We asked better for having me. We've said when you answer comprehension questions, you must answer them in what? Sentences. Remember, I always emphasize on that. What's another name for unemployment? You just write joblessness and you go to number 2. You are failed. You must answer questions in sentences. Another name for unemployment is joblessness. Okay? Give an instance of voluntary unemployment. Give an instance of voluntary unemployment. Yes,
I'm not practice of traditional and just any job.
Because the father has money, the mother has money, family is well. Thank you very much. Okay. How is the rate of unemployment calculated? Okay.
Rate of unemployment is calculated by unemployed workers who are total labor force.
Okay, the unemployment rate is calculated by dividing. For you to tell me dividing by unemployed workers by the total labor force. Okay, thank you very much. And then question 4. What is the labor force? Yes,
labor force is the total number of people working in the country.
Total number of people working in the country, all those working private and public. So when you check them, the total number is what we call the labor force. Alright, number 5. Describe 2 main causes of unemployment in Nigeria.
Yes. The 2 main causes of unemployment are lack of adequate electricity generation and underutilized resources.
The first one is corruption. And that one is what I want to look at, corruption. Then when we have lack of power supply, I mean, you want to do something, but the electricity is not there. It is also a cause for unemployment. Neglect of the agricultural sector. Nobody wants to be a farmer. All of you want to be doctors, engineers, lawyers, lecturers. We are all pursuing right to that jobs. Neglect of the agricultural sector is one of the causes of unemployment. So let's look at the next one. Which one of the following is an effect of unemployment in Nigeria? An effect of unemployment in Nigeria. Is it revolution? Is it right to call a job? stands for unemployment. Okay, we've come to the end. Let's look at draw conclusions on page 157. The first one is deciding the following statements about the passage of bread are true or false. Unemployment affects only children.
False.
There are no cases of voluntary unemployment. There are more jobs than workers in developing countries.
Now that we have had it from our teacher, let's hear it from the students, what they have taken from the lesson.
Welcome from that short break, and now we are into another segment of our radio school evaluation, where we check how far we've gone in the lesson content. We're going to look at page 157, where we have reflect and discuss. Apart from the factors mentioned in the passage, what other factors do you think are responsible for high rates of unemployment? Apart from the ones we have in the test, what other factors do you think are contributing to unemployment? Yes, Lisa.
Other factors that contribute to unemployment.
Awareness should be given on the importance of agriculture to make people indulge and
go into agriculture. Thank you for putting that together for me. Yes, people should be encouraged that a farmer is not the one that you think wear dirty aprons everywhere is smart and so on. We have mechanized farming. We have mechanized farming where you
has been your radio school. We hope you've learned a lot from the lessons you've heard today. Every week, we bring you lessons for JS2 students in maths, English, civic education, and basic science, with a guarantee of lively, good quality instruction from all the teachers.
Dear parents and students, I'm Mr. Bosede Adelaja, Permanent Secretary, Lagos State Ministry of Education. As we are all aware of the present lockdown in Lagos State due to COVID-19 pandemic, which has led to the closure of schools in the state as well, Lagos State Government, through the Ministry of Education, in partnership with Niger FM and South Sahara, has organized a structured and friendly lessons in the following four subjects: English studies, mathematics, basic science, and civic education. For all our junior secondary school students, both private and public, this is to keep our students engaged during the school's closure period. Parents, please inform your children and ones to tune into Niger FM and make the best use of the program, which commences on Monday, 6th April 2020. It is aired every day, Monday to Friday, on Niger FM 102.7 at 12 noon to 1 p.m. daily. God bless you.
This is a Lagos State Government initiative through the Ministry of Education in conjunction with Niger FM and South Saharan. This is a unique opportunity for learning. Grab it with both hands. Radio School, empowering adolescent girls and boys through the power of the radio. This production was brought to you by South Saharan Social Development Organization with support from the MacArthur Foundation USA.